Hey guys, I'm going to demonstrate how I fare in the flexibility test for the side splits as prescribed by Thomas Kurz. So what Thomas Kurz says is if you can basically get your legs like this, then you can go like that, assuming that there's no other impingement. And if you are following this this blog or vlog on account of my posting on the topic of femoroacetabular impingement, then you'll know what that's all about. So I'm going to demonstrate what happens with my hips or with my legs and hips when I perform this test, and I'll show a few different heights and just talk you through where I'm going. So remember, Thomas Kurz says if you can get your legs perpendicular, 90 degrees, then you can get them 180 degrees, all things being equal. Okay, now, just a word of warning, I'm in my underpants, and it's only in order to make sure that you guys can clearly see what's happening with my legs and my hips, because I recorded this with a pair of shorts on, and it wasn't so very clear. So sorry if you don't like seeing me in my underpants, but you don't have to watch this video. So let's get to it. So Thomas Kurz says that if you put your foot on the back of a chair and keep the other leg straight, then you can get a sense of what range of motion your hips allow. I don't have a chair of a suitable height. I'll show you the beginnings of it with this stool. Okay, so you put the stool to one side and place the foot up with the toes pointing up, not like that, so just like that. And then have your foot, knee, hip, shoulder all in one line. If you can stand up straight without tilting over to the side, then you can basically do the splits. Now, this is a bit low, so we're not getting 90 degrees. I'd have to lift my foot. So the next best option I have is this surface here, which is a little too high for me. So what I'm going to do is put on my pair of clogs to give me a bit of extra height because I'm not so tall, and you'll get a better sense of my range of motion. Okay, so that's left foot, or that's right foot. That's left foot on this surface, so you can see pretty straight. Now, just got me a pair of clogs, so they give me an extra, probably an extra inch, which is pretty much what I need, so you'll get a sense of it. Alright, so I'm going to be standing on my right foot, so I need a little extra height on the right. And I'll put my foot up here. So, up, turn it 90 degrees, and you can see that at least according to this theory, I'm more or less, my hips allow more or less the range of movement that one would need for side splits with the toes pointing up. When I bring the toes down, I feel that I'm being pushed this way, so I would have to do something to really open up the hip socket to allow greater range of motion. But if I extend here, you can see that this is more or less what I can do. Make of it what you will, and please let me know what this tells you. So that's with the left foot up, right foot down. Let's have a look on the other side, because we are looking for symmetry. Or at least we want to see what's happening on the other side. So, again, I'll be facing back, but this is why I'm in the undies, so you can see it clearly. So get the foot up, turn it 90 degrees, have the toes pointing up, and make sure that they're pretty much aligned. So wiggle around a bit, and this is what I've got. So that's pretty much it. Now, as far as side splits go, from standing, this is Pretty much as far as I can go. So, if I try to work more on that, I get sore. And especially if I try kicking motions, then that I get particularly sore. This where I raise the knee and try to snap the leg out gives me clicks, so I won't do it, but you get the basic sense. So up and over, up and over. If I give it what I've got, then I get click click, and it's not nice, and I get discomfort and some pain if I persist in doing it. I can do it at a low height, so probably maybe just around waist height, so like that. But if I try to get the knee right up, that's when I run into some trouble. So you can try this yourself. Let me know what you think of the test. Let me know what the results indicate to you. I was not uncomfortable at all in placing my foot up there and rotating my foot 90 degrees. If I had my toes pointing forward, so I'll just do it quickly again. So from here without the clog, a little bit tougher, but still not too bad. So you just play around rotating, get a sense of what it does for you. You can see here I'm really pulling over to the side. If I rotate this way, so externally, and stand up straight, this is what I've got. Now you can see this hip, you can see here's the one point of the hip, here's the other point of the hip, so pretty low. There seems to be a fair height difference. So if I got a bit higher, then I can stand up a bit straighter. So I hope that that's of interest, of use. Sorry about the shirtlessness, pantslessness, but it does make things a lot easier to observe, and I hope that this has been of help to you. Feel free to comment down below, hit me up on Facebook or Google Plus, check my blog, faijournal.blogspot.com. Link, like this video, make it a video response, favorite if you really want to. Thanks for watching, and this is Alex, signing out.